And I also think we have to look at crime in a really important, inquisitive, and civil way. If you look at counties and cities and states, crime is higher in red and Republican states more than it is in liberal cities.
I'm sorry.
Blue cities, crime is going up rampantly. So you can talk about red states, but let's talk about where the crime is happening, the murder capital of Florida.
Can I just address this from an actual factual point, not a deflection?
That was almost a useful conversation. Fox doesn't like to acknowledge inconvenient facts like that. Red states on average tend to have more crime. That's simply indisputable. They don't like to talk about that, but yet it does occasionally crop up. You saw there a woman trying to point out, look, we can talk about Chicago or whatever, but let's be clear, these red states and red cities, she tried to list them but was shouted over, actually have more crime, and they melted down. They could not accept the destruction of their narrative. Now, that doesn't mean that like the crime is specifically because of conservative ideology, but I don't know, that maybe there's something there that we could dive into. We could figure it out, because the goal should be less crime, happier, more satisfied, safer people with a higher quality of life. But that's not their goal. Their goal is the creation and establishment and continuance of a narrative. And they don't like it to be destroyed before their eyes.
That was pure chaos. And I what's interesting to me about this always is the word crime is a very broad word, you know. So it really, to get into it, would then you would need to discuss what those crimes are. Like what are we talking about here? Are we talking about gun deaths? Are we talking about property crime? Like what are we talking about? And then I would also add, like, this Republican thirst to, you know, essentially take over the entire country, which they're already doing. Everything's a red state. So eventually, yeah, there's going to be crime in red states, man, because you've turned everything red.
Too expendable. After spending months on the front lines of the coronavirus pandemic, nurses nationwide could face termination as vaccine mandates take effect in our hospitals. In Colorado alone, 3,800 healthcare facilities are requiring staff to get the shot or get fired by the end of October.
Oh my God, our whole thing could be falling apart, our healthcare industry, because now in some areas, healthcare professionals are being required to not actively transmit COVID to the people they're helping to save. And we've got not just speculation there from Fox, but also anecdotal evidence. Because they eventually went to this segment, they had their nurses fired over vax mandate segment, and then they had a nurse who was fired over a vax mandate. This is Destiny Carpenter, who appeared on Fox and Friends to lament how she was let go from the Colorado hospital where she worked after telling her supervisor that she would not be getting a COVID-19 vaccination despite a clear hospital policy requiring all healthcare workers to do so. So there's multiple issues here. The first being, she could have just gotten the vaccine. And honestly, maybe I'm insane, but it doesn't seem like too much to ask that someone that is like around people with COVID, is treating people for other things other than COVID, might be vaccinated against COVID. That seems reasonable to me. What do you think, Jayar?
Yeah, of course. There's a thing though, but also you can tell from the way that whole thing was posed. It's okay, so there's 3,800 medical nurses that are potentially gonna get, they either have to get the vaccination or get fired. It's encompassing it in this one particular argument that claims they're being fired. They're choosing to leave their jobs. They're not being fired just because they're there. You're not following the same processes. You're not following the rules of the employment. And by the way, that's fine, bro. That's your choice. There's no, hey, no, I want to get vaccinated and stay here. And no, you're fired anyway because we don't like you. No. You made the decision to not do this thing. And the result of that decision is you not working here anymore because it doesn't fit this. If you work for a construction company and you're building a new high rise, you gotta wear a hard hat, you gotta wear steel-toe boots. That's safety, bro. And if you don't want to, because steel-toe boots are kind of uncomfortable and you have wide feet or whatever the hell is wrong with you, then you're gonna have to maybe do something else or deal with it. Which one is it gonna be? But this is the rules of this employment if you wanna work here, or don't be in construction anymore.
Exactly. But Fox has ulterior motives. So first of all, to make it exciting, Like you could presumably have like, you know, one of those big graphics, TYT host fired over refusing to wear pants. Well, like, yeah, there are things that are required of you to work somewhere. And that's not new. We didn't come up with that during the pandemic. It's been around for a while. But that's just one issue. There's at least two others. The second is that they have her on here to rail against vaccine mandates, which are a tyrannical overextension of government power, while not acknowledging that Fox News Media has a vaccine mandate. So she came on a show with a vaccine mandate to talk about how those are dictatorial. They didn't acknowledge that. And at no point did Ainsley Earhart, by the way, who you saw in that video, acknowledge that she's vaccinated or that Fox News requires all their staff members to communicate whether they're vaccinated or be forced to wear masks if they do not.
So Peter, how will the White House spin this? If it is true, as ADP, the paycheck cutter is suggesting, it could be a loss of 300,000 jobs. How is the White House gonna put a happy face on that?
If past is precedent, and usually at the White House it is, he'll come out and he'll say this is just proof that people need to get vaccinated. And he'll say that they've still created more jobs in a year than any president ever, mm-hmm. but that this is an extraordinary time because of COVID, and they want to just. And you know what? He'll probably also, if it goes the way that the last few of these things have gone, push for the Build Back Better plan, because they use that as a catch-all. Right. It's going to create jobs. It's going to lower it's inflation. Like that's the only way to like get Rayman. Anything better.
So, Peter, what vaccine do you get for job loss?
Yeah, I think it's in the trials still.
Okay, good. Yeah, Pfizer's working on it.
That is like one of, other than Joe Rogan and The View, the biggest political show on the planet, Brett. And they were like giddy, like, what's he gonna do if a bunch of people lost their jobs? And younger Ducey at first was sort of keeping it together. Well, I think that they'll come out and say people should get vaccinated. And then I think they would point to the Build Back Better. And did Gutfeld say that it's like Rain Man to them?
Was that
they just
Gutfeld
say
or,
it all the time?
Yeah, they're stupid.
Or Killmead. I get the mix up. Killmead. Didn't he say that?
Yes.
What is wrong
it
with
is
that?
Stupid. That is like saying, if there's a fire, pretty soon they're gonna ask us to like put water on it. Like, there's tons of things in the Build Back Better plan that are for jobs, that will create
definitely
jobs.
Definitely would.
Yeah, but very obviously that misses the absolute fantastic payoff of this story.
Oh, exactly. Well, we'll get to that in one sec, but he also was like, well, they'll point to how they got more jobs ever. Well, but so is that true? Because that seems significant then. Like, why are you glossing over that? But anyway, they're just so giddy at the possibility that 400,000 people would have lost their jobs in the last month. But of course, that isn't what happened. Although we did have enough time for Sean Spicer to jump in on this, tweeting the White House spin on tomorrow's jobs report will be fun. Well, was it fun? Because to jump ahead, the economy actually gained 467,000 jobs in January, and the unemployment rate stayed relatively flat, rising slightly to 4% from 3.9%, according to the new monthly blah, blah, blah from the blah, blah, blah. And here's the thing, Brett. We would never cover this if they wouldn't be so weird about it. Like, I never know how much of any of this can be attributed to the president or the White House or all of it. So we don't generally cover it, whether it's good or bad, Democrat or Republican. But they are so clearly trying to make this into a partisan thing where they can dunk on the Biden administration. Albeit with the broken eggs of that omelet being hundreds of thousands of jobs in the fantasy that they've cooked up.
Right, that's absolutely the most hilarious thing to me is when the economy was in a tailspin thanks to COVID, and let's not forget the wild mismanagement of the early days of the pandemic at the hands of the Trump administration, people on Fox were just like, so pearl clutching, going, how dare you on the left revel in the success your presidential candidate might reap as a result of people dying? Like, they would say, oh, you guys are almost giddy that bad things are happening. That is almost giddy. They are way past giddy. They are miles past mm-hmm. giddy.